So this bandsaw has a bad power switch. It's intermittently working. And it's just a pain to have to deal with. So we're gonna replace it today. Link to everything I use in the video below. It's very straightforward. Let me show you all the tools you'll need. So you're gonna need some Torx bits, specifically a T25, a T20, and a T30. And that's because, unfortunately, all of these screws aren't the same size. I believe these four are T25, these are T20, and then the ones up here are T30. So you'll have to deal with that, or you'll notice that some of these also have slots in them, so you can use a slotted screwdriver. However, you might round it out, so just, invest in some of these, make it that much easier. All we really need to do is, besides unplugging it, is remove all of these. They are all a little bit different. So these bottom two screws are a little bit more fine threaded, whereas the screws here are a little bit more coarse threaded. We flip this guy over. There's two more screws here holding on this half of the bezel. That one's much shorter. So we have a longer one and then a shorter one. Now we should be able to just remove this side. Looks like there is a little hook there, so just know you might have to give it a little pull. Here's our switch. So looks like there's one screw holding it in. It's not a T25, so I'm just gonna go back to the Phillips head, or the flat head, excuse me. Now, fortunately, on this model, it's very straightforward. Looks like we just have to unscrew these connections and then put them on our new switch, and I just want to make sure that they do look the same, so they should fit just fine. And feel free to take a picture of the wiring here. I'm just going to go one wire at a time, so it's hard to screw up. And since I'm here, I'm just gonna clean off these electrical connections with a little brass brush. Now that they're all in, just gonna tighten them down. Now it looks like there's two slots here, one, two, and we just have the wires rest up in there. We can put in the little screw that holds that switch in place. making sure my switch works and that there's nothing in the way. Now what I'm gonna do, just to be a little safe here, is I'm just gonna temporarily lay this on, kind of get it mostly in place, and then plug this bandsaw in. Now that there's no more conductors exposed to me, to see if this new switch works a lot better. Man, like butter. Now let's stitch it all up. Just push down around this cover. And I'm just gonna start dropping a few screws in. Get them barely started. Because if you tighten them all one by one, then you'll have an issue with alignment. Now, since all of these screws are started, their threads are started, now we can just tighten all up. You already know the drill. Questions or comments, put them below. Thanks for watching. Like and subscribe. I'll link some other videos that I've done on these bandsaws in case you have more issues, and hopefully that'll help you out. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.